Hello everyone. Wishing you all a very good afternoon. How are you doing? Am I audible and visible to all? Good afternoon, Yarika Abhiram. I hope you are doing fine. Okay. To begin the class, we begin with the same instructions. Keep your mobile phones off. Mobile cameras off. Sit in a place where you get good network so that the video doesn't hang. Good afternoon, Tanu. Great to see you in the class and interacting. The class becomes interesting and fun when you interact, when you talk. If you don't talk, you just keep mum. The class becomes boring. I get bored, you get bored. It's a waste of time for everyone. So I hope that you interact. Sit in a place where you get good connection, good network. If you have to chat, send your message on the ID of AskTech. I've logged in by two IDs. So either you go onto the ID of AskTech or go to into the ID of everyone. Both cases I can see. In any case, I have allowed you to unmute yourself. So if I ask you a direct question, you can very well unmute yourself and give me the answer. Well, I had given you one question for homework. Well, only Niharika has done it, that too just now. She sent me the message of that question. I hope that all of you, I have asked her to put it in the group. So I hope that all of you would see it in the group. I think she has put it also. Well done, Niharika. So I hope that all of you would see that question and solve it and put your answers. So I will not discuss that question, but I'll be discussing some other questions. And this is a question that again I asked you to do it as homework just for yesterday. I don't know whether you have tried this or not. But let us discuss this question today. And the question is pretty simple. A and B, as you can see here, A and B are two balls which are thrown upwards with 5 meters per second and 10 meters per second respectively. So you have two balls thrown up, 5 meters and 10 meters. G key value is given as 10 meter per second square, which is normally the case to keep calculation simpler. Find the separation between them after 1 second. So that is the question that we are looking at. We have to find the separation between the two balls after 1 second. Now, most of the cases, as I told you, if you apply the right concept, you will always end up with the right answer. I'm not worried about the answers as of now. As of now, I'm more worried. I'm more concerned about how you are going to solve this question. So I'll give you time, 1 minute, 2 minutes. I think there are new students as well coming into the class for the first time. I think Vallabha, Navya, I think, are from the new batch. I don't know how much of this would make sense to you, but let us see. If you can understand something, that would be pretty nice. A and B are thrown vertically upwards with velocity 5 meters per second and 10 meters per second respectively. G is 10. Find the separation between them after 1 second. How do we attack such a problem? How do we solve such a problem? If you have any thoughts, please raise your hands and then we can discuss it. Getting the answer is the last of our concerns. We'll get an answer, don't worry. We'll get an answer. The concern right now for us is how we do it. So I'm open for thoughts. Who will give me from start. How should I do it? I have to find the separation between them after 1 second. I know these, the initial velocities. How will I do this? Anyone would like to say anything? Please raise hands. What do you think about the question? Read the question. I'll stay quiet for 1-2 minutes. Let all of you read the question and then we'll ask. Then we will discuss. 2 minutes. A and B, two balls thrown up, 5 meters per second, 10 meters per second, G is 10 meters per second square, separation after 1 second. You must understand that there are many ways of solving a question in physics. We are looking for the smartest, quickest way. Smartest and the quickest. And my students generally, with due course and time, will get to the smartest way of doing it. Anyone, any thoughts? How will you do this? Niharika, Abhiram, Tanu, Tarun. You are the old students. Any idea how you do this? You are like seniors in this class, but the rest have just joined probably. You should take the onus of taking the first step. How are we going to solve this question? Well, one way is this way, in which the question is already solved. Abhiram, you can let me see. You've written something. Abhiram says, sir, like by finding the distance traveled by them in 1 second and then subtracting the difference, which will be the separation. That is absolutely correct, Abhiram. That is how you can always do it. And that is how the first solution in the notes is given. Now, the solution is given in here. What I'll ask all of you to read the solution from here to here, what I have marked, read the solution quietly and tell me if you have understood how it is done. I give you 2 minutes more to read the solution. And then one of you or many of you would raise hands. And then I'll ask you what they've understood by reading the solution. That is the solution right in front of your eyes. Anyone tell me what they have done? Abhiram, Niharika. Niharika is coming up with her own way of solving it. Yes, Niharika, we are going to do it by the same way that you are suggesting. But right now, what I am telling you is how they have done this. How they have done this. Abhiram, can you unmute yourself and tell me how they have done this? और निहारिका सर अभिराम से कान अनम्यूट. निहारिका कैन यू अनम्यूट एंड टेल मी हाउ दे हैव डन दिस. और तनु और विशाल और तरुण और अक्षय और नव्या और ऐश्वर्या इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस क्वेश्चन. Anyone can tell me how they have done this question?
By substituting the values of initial velocity.
Ashwarya, your voice is breaking in between. Yes, I think you are right. Can you again try?
By substituting the values.
By substituting the values given. Okay. Let me describe it further. What Aishwarya has told us is they have put the values. But by putting the values, what have they done, Aishwarya? What are they calculating? Maybe my question was not clear to all of you. Yes, Niharika. Niharika, unmute yourself. Can you unmute yourself?
Sir, can you hear me?
Yes, but I can hear you. Tell me what they have done.
Sir, first they found the displacement of A with respect to ground.
You have found out the displacement of A with respect to ground. Whatever is given to us is all with respect to ground. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
The initial velocity is plus 5 of A with respect to ground. The acceleration is minus 10 of A with respect to ground. And they have found the displacement of A with respect to ground. How much is that coming, Niharika?
Sir, it's 0.
0 means it has gone up and it has come back to its original position. Do you all agree on this? Can I have raised hand that we have understood this much? That the first step that they have done is calculate the displacement of A with respect to ground, put the values, as Niharika said, put the values, get the answer, stay happy. Tanu, Tarun, Vallabha, Vashant, Navya, do we understand this? Okay, Niharika, what next? What they have done next?
Sir, we have to find the displacement of B with respect to ground.
So, they have now put the formula and found the displacement of B with respect to ground. The initial velocity is given as plus 10. As you can see here, it is given as plus 10. Acceleration is minus because it is downwards. We all understand this. What is the answer that we are getting for displacement of B with respect to ground, Niharika?
Sir, it's 5.
It's 5 meters. So the displacement of B with respect to ground is plus 5 actually. Plus 5 means it is upwards. Upwards from ground. Then what they have done, Niharika?
Sir, later we have to subtract the displacement of A with displacement of B.
So A is on ground. B is 5 meter upwards. So what is the separation between the two? The separation between the two is definitely 5 meters. So this is the way they have done it. It is absolutely right. There is no doubt in this way. You can easily do it in this way. But my question here is there any more nicer way, smarter way? You can see you have to do a lot of calculations here. First, you have to put the formula for displacement of A with respect to ground, then put the values, get the answer, then again displacement of B with respect to ground, again put the values, again get the answer, then subtract both, and then get the final answer. Niharika, my question to Niharika and all of you is there a different way in which we can do it smarter and faster? This is absolutely correct. There's no problems with this one. But can we think of a different way of doing it? Anyone thinks that there can be a different way? Please raise hand so that we can discuss how we can do it in a different way. Niharika, tell me, what is a different way that you are looking at?
So simply we have to find the initial velocity of A with respect to B.
Okay, so basically Niharika is saying that we find the initial velocity of A with respect to B. How do we do this, Niharika?
Sir, initial velocity of A with respect to B equals to initial velocity of A with respect to ground minus initial velocity of B with respect to ground.
Very correct. This is the formula that we have already studied in the previous class. What next?
Sir, it is plus 5 minus plus 10.
Initial velocity of A with respect to ground is plus 5. All of us can see this. Minus initial velocity of B with respect to ground is plus 10. So what do we get, Niharika, from here?
Sir, it is minus 5.
Minus 5 meter per second is the initial velocity of A with respect to B. Okay, Niharika, we have got this. What next? What should I do next? I always told you, and I always keep on telling you, study or learning is a team game. So if Niharika is stuck somewhere, any one of you can help her out. Niharika has helped us in finding out the initial velocity of A with respect to B. Can anyone help her out and tell all of us, what should be the next step? What should be the next step?
Sir, we need to find the acceleration of A with respect to B.
Well done, Niharika. If no one helps you, then you help yourself. Well, good spirit, Niharika. What will be the acceleration of A with respect to B? It's simple. It will be the acceleration of
Sir,
A with respect to...
Sir, it is acceleration of A with respect to ground minus acceleration of B with respect to ground.
And how much will the value come?
Sir, it's 10 minus minus of 10.
Minus 10, minus of minus 10. Both are minus 10. Yes or no, beta?
It's 0, sir.
So that is a very important thing. Since both are moving under gravity, both are having same acceleration due to gravity, their acceleration with respect to each other becomes 0. Do we all understand this? Do we all understand this, sir? Yes, we understand this. Both acceleration, they cancel out each other. Let me just make a small thing. Okay. Both acceleration, they cancel out each other. Great. What next, Niharika? What is the next step? See, again, she's thinking. Meanwhile, she is thinking, can anyone help her? What should be the next step? Learning is a team sport.
Sir, time is given as 1 second.
See, no one helps her. So she comes up with her own answer. That is the spirit. Time is 1 second. What do I do next, Niharika?
Sir, later we have to find the displacement of A with respect to B.
Well done. You have to find the displacement of A with respect to B. And what is the formula for that? Anyone would like to help her? She has done exceedingly well up till now. She's thinking about the formula. Anyone can help her? Niharika doesn't seem to have friends in this class. Not bad, not good. All of you should have friends. Abhiram can't unmute himself. Aishwarya, Akshay, Vishal, Tanu, Tarun, Vasan Sai. Can anyone help Aishwarya? If you can't unmute, you can type. That will also be helping her. You can type the answer, what you think, and I will communicate it to Niharika. That beta, this is what is displacement of A with respect to B. How much is that?
Sir, I will tell the formula.
Tell me.
Sir, displacement of A with respect to B equals to initial velocity of A with respect to B multiplied by T plus half into acceleration of A with respect to B multiplied by time square.
Very good. That is the formula. we also know that, we also know what, that this is zero, so this goes away. So what remains is initial velocity of A with respect to B. How much is that? It is minus 5 multiplied by time. How much is that, Aishwarya and Niharika?
It's 1, sir.
So my answer is minus 5 meters. So basically, displacement of A with respect to B is minus 5. So what does it tells me? What does it tell me is that when I become B and I look at A, A is 5 meters below me. Yes or no? When I become B, because we have calculated everything with respect to B, so you have become B. So when you look at B, when you become B, where is A? A is 5 meters below. Why it is below? Because it is minus. Are you getting my point? A is 5 meters below B, and therefore the separation between A and B is 5 meters, and that is the final answer. We have done the same question. On the left hand side, in the blue separation, behind the blue separation on the left hand side, the entire question has been done with respect to ground. On the right hand side, with the help of Niharika, we have done the same question with respect to B. We got the same answer. We always will get the same answer. That is why I'm telling you, answers don't matter. What matters is we do it in the quickest way. Now, how does right wala become quicker? Because this acceleration wala term becomes zero. The entire acceleration wala term becomes zero. And as soon as this acceleration wala term becomes zero, our calculation reduces. And hence, we get the answer more quickly. Do we understand this? Can I have some raise hand? Do we understand the question, how it is done with the help of Niharika? She has done it exceedingly well. Can I have some reason that we have understood this? Starting from Vashant, Tarun, Tanu, Vishal, Akshay, Abhiram, Nayan, Navya, Aishwarya, have you understood this? Can I have some raised hands? That's how we have understood this. Only Abhiram has understood this. Tarun also seems to understand. Nayan never responds. Vishal, Tanu, Navya has also understood this. Well done, Navya. I was not expecting that you will understand this. Well done, Navya. Navya has understood this. Then probably Aishwarya would also understand this. Vishal, Nayan, Akshay, they never speak. Tanu, what about you? Tanu, Vashant, have you understood this? I will repeat this again. How we have done this? First of all, we have found out the initial velocity of A with respect to B. We are solving the entire question with respect to B. We get the value of initial velocity as minus 5 meter per second. Then we find out the acceleration of A with respect to B. We get the acceleration as 0 of A with respect to B because both are under gravity. We know the value of time is 1 second. Then we use the formula for displacement of A with respect to B. Initial velocity of A with respect to B into t plus half acceleration of A with respect to B into t square. This term is definitely 0. So I get the displacement of A with respect to B as minus 5. That means, listen to me carefully. When you become B, A is 5 meters below you. So the separation between A and B becomes 5 meters. I hope this is clear to all of you. If you have any doubts, now you can raise your doubt. Please let me know if there is a doubt. We would like to clear it now. Else, we will move on to the next thing. Okay. This tells me that there is no doubt as of now. In any point in time, you feel any doubt, you can always put your doubt in the Telegram group. At any point in time, you feel that you have not understood anything, I guess these lectures are available to you in the app. You can definitely watch the lecture again. Don't understand it still, I am always there. As soon as you put your doubts and as soon as I see them, I would be able to clear them. Okay. Let us move ahead now. And the next topic is what is before this. And the name of this topic is velocity of approach and velocity of separation. Velocity of approach and velocity of separation. Anyone, any idea about what this could be? Again, answers don't matter. Right answer, there are no right answer, there are no wrong answers. As I told you, everything in this universe is relative. You look at this phone, someone will see it like this, someone will see it like this, someone will see it like this. You're looking at the same thing from different angles. It looks different. Nothing is right. Nothing is wrong. What matters is what you think. What do you mean by velocity of approach? And what do you mean by velocity of separation? Now, let us go away with the word velocity. What do you mean by approach? And what do you mean by separation? Simple English terms. And I am very, very sure that you are way far better than me in English. You understand? What do you mean by approach and what do you mean by separation? What do you mean by approach first? When do you say what is approach? When do we call something approaching you? Anyone? Yes, Niharika. Approach means something is coming nearer. Very nicely said, Niharika. Approach means something is coming near to you. If that is approach, what is separation?
Differentiating
two things. Aishwarya, what do you mean by differentiating two things? See, approach means something is coming closer to you. Approach means something is coming nearer to you. Separation means something is going away from you. It's going farther, it's going away. Yes or no? Do you understand it, Aishwarya?
Yes, sir.
The other way of saying this is the distance or the separation is decreasing. Do we understand this? If there are two bodies and their distance is decreasing or their separation is decreasing, we will call it that they are approaching each other. Velocity of separation. If their separation is increasing, their distance is increasing, we will call it separation. Yes or no? Do we understand this? You all understand this? Niharika says yes, sir. So I will assume that Niharika speaks for the entire class. Now, let us take some examples. Life is nothing without an example. And let us take the example of two things moving along a straight line. this is B and this is A. A is moving with a velocity of plus 10 meter per second, let us say, towards right or towards forward. B is moving with a velocity of minus 5 meter per second. Minus because it is in the opposite direction, towards left. Now, we have also seen that you find the velocity of A with respect to B, or you find the velocity of B with respect to A. They're always related to each other. Velocity of A with respect to B and velocity of B with respect to A are related to each other. And how are they related? Velocity of A with respect to B and velocity of B with respect to A, how are they related? Anyone? They are inverse of each other. Yes, Niharika. Inverse means they are negative of each other. Negative means they are opposite of each other. If velocity of A with respect to B is plus 5, velocity of B with respect to A would be minus 5. They are opposite vectors, opposite direction. Now, in this case that I have written, you find the velocity of A with respect to B, or you can find out the velocity of B with respect to A. We can do that. We will solve a question and do it. That is not the concern right now. The concern is when they are moving like each other, when they are moving towards each other like this, is their separation increasing or is their separation decreasing? Is their distance between them increasing or is the distance between them decreasing? Are they approaching each other or are they separating from each other? Are they approaching each other or are they separating from each other? Their distance or separation is decreasing. Their distance or separation is decreasing. Let me call this as case number one. In case number one, their distance or separation is decreasing. Yes or no? Can I have some raise hand that we understand this, sir? Their distance or separation is decreasing. Yes or no? Can I have some raise hands? Only two people have understood this. What about Tanu? Tanu, after saying good morning, has not spoken up. Vasant, Vishal, Navya. Okay, great. Good participation. So their distance between them is decreasing. Now, if I find velocity of A with respect to B, or velocity of B with respect to A, that velocity will be known as velocity of approach. So if the distance between two bodies is decreasing, please mark my words. You can't write, don't worry, I'll send you the PDF. You have this study material with you already. If the distance between two bodies is decreasing, we call their relative velocity as the velocity of approach. They are approaching each other. They are moving towards each other. They are going to meet each other. Am I clear? Do I understand this? Do we understand this? Okay, that is known as velocity of approach. Let us look at case number two. In case number two, I have created a similar scenario. This is B, this is A. It is moving with plus 10 meter per second. It is moving with plus 5 meter per second. This is case number two. In this case, I can find the velocity of A with respect to B, or I can find the velocity of B with respect to A. They will be opposite of each other. We all know this. Now tell me, in this case, is the distance between them increasing or decreasing? Is the separation between them increasing or decreasing? Are they approaching each other or are they separating from each other? This is not a question of physics. This is a question of common sense. What is happening to their distance or their separation? Are they approaching each other or are they separating from each other? The piche wala bike or car is moving with plus 10 meter per second. The aage wala car is moving with plus 5. Will the distance decrease or will the distance increase? The distance will definitely decrease. Yes, beta, it will definitely decrease. Piche wali car is faster. Aage wali car is slower. Dono ke beech ka distance will definitely decrease. After some time, we had seen in the previous class, car A will overtake car B. What happens after that is different. Before, car A overtakes car B. Before car A overtakes car B, car A is behind and it is faster. Car A is ahead, but it is slower. Distance between them will decrease and therefore their relative velocity will also be known as velocity of approach. They are approaching each other. One car is aage, other car is piche. The front car is moving slower. The back car is moving faster. The distance between them will decrease and hence it will be known as velocity of approach. Am I clear? Can I have raised hand that we have understood this? Great, great, great. Now let us look at the third scenario. There is definitely going to be a third scenario. And third scenario will occur in this way, let us say. Now, as Niharika pointed out, or as I said, at some point in time, A will overtake B. And I have drawn the diagram in that scenario. Now, A is moving ahead with a velocity of plus 10 meter per second. B is following it with a velocity of plus 5 meter per second. Now tell me, you guys, is the separation between them or the distance between them increasing or decreasing? Distance between them, is it increasing or decreasing? A is faster and he is ahead. B is slower and he is falling behind. Will the distance between them increase or decrease? Yes, in this case, the distance will increase. If the separation between them is increasing, which is happening in case 3, then the relative velocity of A with respect to B or relative velocity of B with respect to A will be known as velocity of separation. Why is it known as velocity of separation? Because they are now getting separated. Am I clear with this? Am I clear with this concept of velocity of approach or the velocity of separation? Can I have some raised hand that we understand this, sir? Abhiram, Niharika, Tarun, Aishwarya, great. Nayan, Navya, Vishal, Tanu, Vasant Sai. Great, I'm having some great participants today. Navya is also understanding. Navya and Aishwarya, I'm really happy with you. Aishwarya, have you understood this? Great. Now, If you have understood this, velocity of approach, velocity of separation, this is forward, it is positive. This is backwards, it is negative. Here comes the question. And the question is a very simple one, asked in NEET many times, starting from 15 to 17 to 20. Not the same values, the values have changed. Doesn't matter. The question is right in front of your eyes. A particle A, as you can see, this is the gentleman A. The particle A is moving with a speed of 10 meters per second towards right. This is this. Another particle B is moving with a speed of 12 meters per second towards left. First of all, tell me, one is moving right, one is moving left towards each other. Will you call it velocity of separation or will you call it velocity of approach? First, give me this answer. Answers don't matter. What matters is if you understood the question or not. That is my first. This will be known as Niharika says, velocity of approach, and that is what they have asked. Find the velocity of approach. I will be waiting for your answers. If you get the answer, please raise your hand. Doesn't matter if it is wrong or right. No wrong, no right. It's your point of view that matters. So I'm waiting for your answers. Whosoever gets an answer, please raise hand. I will ask you to solve the question. Plus 22 meter per second is their velocity of approach. You don't have to say plus velocity of approach or separation. We are only talking about its magnitude. Niharika, can you unmute yourself and tell me how you have done this?
So we have to find the velocity of A with respect to B.
Okay, we have to find the velocity of A with respect to B. How do you suppose to do this?
So it is velocity of A minus velocity of B.
Velocity of A with respect to?
Ground. Minus velocity of B with respect to ground.
Well done. How much is this?
So it is plus 10.
Plus means it is forward and 10 is the magnitude, right? Minus, what is the velocity of B with respect to ground?
So it is minus 12.
It is minus 12. Minus because it is backwards, so it is minus. Plus because it is forward. So what do I get?
So it is 22 meter per second.
Plus 22, plus indicating its direction. Now we have to understand whether it is velocity of separation or velocity of approach. What is this? Separation or approach?
Approach.
It is velocity of approach. Why is that so, Niharika?
Because it is nearer.
Because the separation is decreasing, or as he said, they are getting nearer to each other. You can mark this word nearer. They are getting near to each other. Well done, Niharika. You've done it very nicely, in a nice way. If you had appeared in all these needs, you could have scored plus 4 here. Do you all understand this, the rest of the team? How this question was done by Niharika? Do you understand this? Ashwari understand this. What about the rest? Tanu, Tarun, Vallabh, Vashant, Vishal, Akshay, Navya. Great. Tanu has raised her hand first time. I am very pleased to see Tanu responding back. Great. That is a good sign. I hope that one day I'll see all the hands raised up, not in doubt, but when I ask that you have solved the question, it probably all of you will raise hand. So one day, that day will come. Let's hope so. Okay, Niharika normally gives most of the answer. I would expect that someone else also does it. I would be very pleased. And this is the next question. I think it's question number 5 from your notes. A particle A is moving with a speed of 20 meters per second towards right. Another particle B is moving with a speed of 5 meters per second towards right. The diagram is shown. Now, first look at the diagram and tell me whether it is velocity of separation or the velocity of approach. Whether it is separation or approach. Aishwarya has come up with an answer. Great, Aishwarya. I'm very pleased to see your answer. Good. It is approach because they are getting nearer to each other. Aishwarya has given this answer. So I will ask Aishwarya. Tanu, you have also got the answer? Great. Navya has also got the answer. Great. So Navya, can you unmute yourself and tell me how you have got this answer? I don't think Navya can unmute herself. Tanu, can you unmute yourself and tell me what is the answer? How did you get the answer? Okay. Aishwarya, your turn. Unmute yourself.
Velocity of AB is equal to?
Velocity of A with respect to B is equal to?
Velocity of A respect to ground minus?
Minus?
Velocity of B respect to ground.
That is good. What next?
20
plus 20 plus 20. Why it is plus beta? It is going forward. That is why it is plus. Yes. Minus. What is the velocity?
Minus of less.
Plus 5. Why it is plus 5? Because it is also moving forward. Well done. What do you get from here, Aishwarya?
It is 15, sir.
Plus 15 beta. Don't forget plus. Without plus, you don't see direction. Velocity is a vector. Without direction, vector does not make sense. Will you remember that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have got the velocity of A with respect to B as plus 15, Aishwarya. Now tell me whether it is velocity of approach or velocity of separation.
Velocity of approach.
Velocity of approach, right answer. What is the reason behind it?
Because separation is decreasing.
Because separation is decreasing, or as Niharika says, they are getting nearer to each other. So the answer is 15 meter per second. Do we all understand this? Aishwarya has clarified it in very simple and nice and sweet language. Her voice, all your voices, everyone, so sweet. Your kids, you are just like, I feel so happy talking to you, hearing your voice. There's a cuteness behind it. There's a sweetness behind it. And it makes my day nice. So, in our sweet little voice, Aishwarya has given us the answer. How many of you agree that is correct and we understand this? Else you will have to listen to the same one in my harsh, stupid voice. Niharika seems to have understood this. What about the others? Navya, Abhiram, Akshay, Vishal, Tanu, Vallabh, Vasant. Have you understood this? Great, see? Navya, see, wow. See, my voice no one wants to listen to, but when it comes to Aishwarya or Niharika, for that matter, everyone listens and understands. So from now onwards, I would ask more of you to participate more of you to give your answers, give your solution in your sweet little voices. And that would probably make the class more interactive, more fun. See, I can't start dancing over here for you to get entertained. The only way I can entertain you is probably in this way. That is how I know to entertain. Probably a joke here and there, maybe. If I am not very good at jokes, so I can't entertain you. The only way I can entertain you is by solving questions. That is the only way I know of entertainment. Now, let us go back and solve one question which I had planned to solve. And how do I do this? First, I'll have to go here. Then I will have to go here, and then I will solve this one. Where is my share screen? This is my share screen. This is here. This is here. And this is the question. This is how actually I wanted to start your class, but then we moved on to that one. This is a question that has been asked many times. Not in need to, maybe once or twice in need. But that makes a very wonderful question to understand the concept of relative velocity. And I will try my hand. This question might be a little bit tough from the standards of NEET. But see, if you have to score good marks, 600 plus, 620, somewhere around 620, 630, you have to get 150, 140 to 150 in physics, 140 to 150 in chemistry. So that makes to around 190 or to 300, then around 340 in bio. That will take you to that target score of 620 plus. And that is how you have to do it. 10 meters is the height of this tower. What I'm going to do is I'm going to throw one ball up from point A with a velocity of plus 20, plus indicating that it is upwards. At the same time, I'm going to drop a ball from B. When you drop something, the velocity is zero, the vertical velocity is zero. So the question, the language of the question will be like this. A ball is thrown up from point A with velocity 20 meters per second. At the same time, a ball is dropped. Dropped means vertical velocity is zero. Dropped from a height of 10 meters. Now, they're obviously moving in a straight line. They will meet each other. This is a similar question to like what we had done, where two cars, one car was ahead, the second car was faster, it was behind, it was meeting. The only case is, here it is, they are moving in opposite direction. There they were moving in the same direction. Here in the opposite direction. Here in the opposite direction, previous question, same direction. So, stone is dropped from a height of 10 meters. When and where do they meet? That is the question. When and where they meet? G, if required, is 10 meters per second square. That is the question that we are looking at. And I'm looking at some answers. Again, answers are not important. The important part is that you have understood the question. The important part is that you have understood the question. Read the question carefully. Read the question carefully. I give you 2 minutes to read it. Again, I'm not looking at answers. Answers are the least important things in my life, your life as well. The only thing I want to see here is the approach that you do. How do you approach it? How do you think about the question? How do you think that this question can be solved? That approach matters. Answers, eventually you will get. Eventually means, if you do the right process over and over again, you will get the answer. I have no doubt on this. Lord Krishna has also said in Mahabharata, do your karma. Don't worry about the fruit of the karma. Don't worry about the results. Don't worry about the answer. That is what I am saying. That doesn't mean that I am Lord Krishna. Just taking inspiration from him. Do your karma. Your karma is to think how you are going to do it. Try it. Answers will come. Answers are not in your hands. If your karma is correct, the answer would be correct. The fruit would be good. If your karma is not correct, you will understand that you have done some mistake. Correct it. Correct your karma. You will get the answer. That is how life goes. I hope you have read the question. What do you think about the question? How are you going to solve it? Anyone with any thought? No thought is stupid. No thought is foolish. It's only the way. It's only the way you imagine it that matters right now. And that is the only thing that will ever matter in anyone's life. It's how you think about it. So anyone would like to say, how are you going to solve it? What are your thoughts? Read the question carefully. You might not be able to solve it today. I'm in no hurry to solve it. Time is one thing that can't be brought back. But I can't rush it. Just because your class is getting over, I just can't solve a question in a hurry. We'll do it in the next class. The most important thing is that you understand the question and you give me your thoughts on it. How are you going to do it? Aishwarya, Navya, Abhiram, I think has left. Tanu, more girls here in this class. Then guys, Tarun, Vishal, Akshay, Vasant. How are you going to solve this question? What do you think about the question? First of all, what is asked? I hope it is clear. When and where they meet? Same as the last question that we discussed in the last class. When and where they meet? What are your thoughts? Anyone? Okay, so I leave this question as it is. I leave this question as a homework for you. This question now becomes a homework question. And when I give homework, I know that you can solve this, even if I have not told you anything about it. Because probably I have told you some things which don't realize at this point. So I'll give you some time to think about this question. You can put your thoughts in the Telegram group. If you want to message me personally, you can message your thoughts personally, how you can do this. You can also send me photographs of what you have done. And then I'll tell you whether it's correct or not, how to approach it again. So on that note, I will end today's class. I hope that you try this question. Every question will make you understand something. And that is why each and every question that we do is important. So, we'll solve this question in the next class. I'm leaving this as a homework. Do let me know what your thoughts are. And we'll discuss it in the group. Till then, I'll call this class off. The class stands dismissed. I hope that you stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy. Meet again tomorrow. Till then, take care, enjoy your life, study hard, party harder. There's no time to party right now, but study hard right now. Okay? Let me know your thoughts on this question before saying bye-bye. Bye-bye, everyone. Take care.